everybody. Welcome back to another awesome day, another awesome vlog. Today I'm going to share with you some of the tips I've learned and give you some reviews on 4 different brands of makeup that I use. The first one I want to talk about is e.l.f. e.l.f. stands for eyes, lips, face. e.l.f. was founded in 2004 and they currently have over 300 products on the market. They mainly sell makeup, but they do also sell beauty tools and a skincare line as well. One of the things that's amazing about e.l.f. is their price point. The majority of the items that they have on the market are listed for $1, $3, or $6, which is very, very reasonable for makeup, especially when it comes to foundation. For example, they have a really, really great foundation that sells for $6. It is a full coverage foundation. It goes on very, very smoothly, but I have found in order to get the best coverage, you need to use an e.l.f. primer under it. The e.l.f. primer sells for $3, so together it's only $9 for a great primer and a foundation. That is a very reasonable price. The other thing that e.l.f. sells that I really like is their mascara. It is volumizing mascara. It's only $3. It is really, really thick and it is amazing. I love it. They have a makeup mist and setting spray. It's only $3 as well. I like that it doesn't have a strong scent. The sprayer is actually really great. I've used some setting sprays that it's such a heavy spray that it's almost shocking when it hits your face. This sprayer is perfect and gentle. I love it. The next makeup brand that I'd like to talk about is Ulta Beauty. Ulta Beauty, as I'm sure you know, is a store, but they also sell their own brand of makeup. Ulta Beauty actually opened, it was called Ulta Salon in 1990, and in 2017, they changed their name to Ulta Beauty officially. Also in 2017, they started carrying MAC products, which will be the next line of beauty products that I talk about. But first, let's talk about the Ulta Beauty brand for a moment. One of the things that's really great is Ulta Beauty will put together a lot of packages where you can get about 10 to 12 of their items in their beauty line for only about $19.99, and sometimes then they have a coupon that you can use on top of that. Ulta Beauty will give you little sets of eyeshadow. This is an illuminator I received in a pack. A full-size lipstick, a full-size mascara, and a full-size eyeshadow palette. The only thing I have found that I don't love about Ulta Beauty products is I don't care necessarily for the eyeshadow palette. It's not very pigmented. It takes a lot to make the color actually show the way you'd like it to show up, but all in all, their products are very reasonably priced, and I think they work fairly good. I've never used their foundation, but I did look into it, and their foundation runs about $14, which is, it's a pretty reasonable price point for a foundation. But like I said, I've never used it, so I can't tell you whether I like it or what the coverage is like. The next product, like I mentioned, that I was going to discuss is MAC. I love MAC. I have used MAC off and on for many, many years. Since we're talking about foundations, I'm not currently using any of their foundations, but generally their price point for foundation is about $30. MAC is one of the things that I love is their packaging. Everything is just small and compact, but all of their, for example, this is an eyeshadow, the dishes are actually really deep, so they last for a very, very long time. My favorite thing, however, about MAC is their lipstick and their lip liners. Their lip liners are very pigmented, they go on smooth, but their lipsticks and lip glosses do not have a funny smell or a funny taste. A lot of brands I find, they just are kind of a turnoff to me because they just have a makeup taste to them and I just tend to not wear them. MAC lipstick goes on smooth, has no taste, and it's long lasting. So I highly recommend, even for the cost, any lipsticks or lip glosses from MAC. The last company I want to talk about is Urban Decay. Urban Decay actually started in 1996, and they are currently owned by L'Oreal. L'Oreal has purchased that company. Urban Decay is a little more expensive. most of their foundations start at $40. I have used one of their foundations and I absolutely love it. It has great coverage. It is a skin matching foundation, so you put it on and it just somehow adapts to your skin color easily and it matches perfectly. But one of the other things I really, really love about Urban Decay is their packaging. They have beautiful packaging and all of their products are a high quality as well. This is actually something that I use daily. It comes with the bronzer, the contour, and the blush, and I love it. One of the things that Urban Decay is really known for is their Naked eyeshadow palettes, and they get great reviews, but they do run about $55. I've never tried any of them, but someday I probably will pick one up, and when I do, I'll let you know what I think, but I have heard that they're really, really great. As far as brushes are concerned, I would always recommend MAC. They just have a smoothness to them. They clean easily and they're very, very long lasting. I've had some MAC brushes for about 15 years and they're still like brand new when I clean them up. I hope you enjoyed my video and I hope you learned something about some of the price points. I did try to talk about some makeup that is in a lower price point and compare it to some of the makeup in a higher price point. Thanks so much for watching. Don't forget to smash the thumbs up button and don't forget to subscribe.